Pope Benedict XVI is being remembered the world over as one of the greatest theologians of his age. The 95-year-old became known as God's Rottweiler and was the first pontiff to resign from the role in 600 years.
The end of a year and the end of an era.
That was sorrow. We inform you that the Pope Emeritus Benedict XVI passed away today, this morning, at 9:34.
After almost a decade of two popes, now just one, Pope Francis leading the tributes to his predecessor. With emotion, we remember his person, so noble, so kind, he told the faithful in his New Year's Eve address, reflecting on Benedict's goodness while meeting crowds outside the Vatican. Pope Emeritus Benedict XVI was born Joseph Alois Ratzinger in Germany in 1927. He was just six when the Nazis took power, undertaking mandatory service for the Hitler Youth Movement. By 1977, he was appointed Archbishop of Munich. An intellectual giant, he was given the nickname God's Rottweiler for his uncompromisingly conservative views. In 2005, and at the age of 78, he was chosen for the Catholic Church's most powerful position.
Pope Benedict, in his own right, would be up there amongst the three or four greatest theologian popes, the greatest thinker, teacher popes in the whole 2,000 years of the Church's history.
Benedict's relationship with Australia, a complicated one. He gave the nation our first saint, canonising St Mary MacKillop in 2008.
Was a very important gift to this country.
Before apologising to child sex abuse victims in Melbourne.
Indeed, I am deeply sorry for the pain and suffering the victims have endured.
But Benedict himself was accused of covering up the crimes of paedophile priests during his time in Munich. He would later admit errors had been made. The Catholic Church facing an existential crisis during his tenure, the revelations of sexual abuse only escalating, and the Vatican accused of corruption. And then, 8 years into his papacy, and amid mounting speculation around his health, he resigned. The first pontiff in 600 years to step down from a job which is traditionally until death. But he would keep his papal name, choosing to be called Pope Emeritus Benedict, spending his final days at a monastery here at the Vatican, where many are now coming to pay their respects.
Great legacy of his interpretations, his intellectual interpretations of Christian doctrine.
It's really sad, but I think that God was waiting for his time on this day.
In Germany, flags have been lowered. In his hometown, bells tolled. World leaders honouring him with words. US President Joe Biden, who was only the second Catholic to hold office after John F. Kennedy, met Benedict in 2011, remembering his generosity and welcome, as well as our meaningful conversation. King Charles recalling his constant efforts to promote peace and goodwill to all people. From French President Emmanuel Macron, my thoughts go out to Catholics in France and around the world. And from our Prime Minister Anthony Albanese, may he rest in eternal peace. The 95-year-old's death brings to an end an unprecedented period of history, the world now reflecting on the legacy of its 265th Pope.
Carrie-Anne Greenbank joins us now from the Vatican. And Carrie, this is uncharted territory for the Church. What happens now?
Well, it is, Georgie, and the Vatican has released details of what we can expect from now. So what we know is that the former Pope Benedict's body will be lying in state at St Peter's Basilica from tomorrow morning local time. Then on Thursday morning, the funeral mass will be held here at St Peter's Square. It will be presided over by Pope Francis. That alone is unprecedented. Then Benedict's body will be buried in the tombs under the basilica. But the Vatican is yet to say, yet to confirm how elaborate the funeral will be and who will be invited. But just to give you some perspective, when Pope John Paul II died in 2005, that funeral mass lasted for 3 hours here at St Peter's Square. It was attended by around 4 million people, and at the time it was widely considered to be the largest funeral of its kind in modern history. Of course, he was still a pope. He died in office. So Pope Emeritus Benedict's funeral is not expected to be quite to that scale, Georgie.
Carrie-Anne Greenbank, thank you.